Four centuries ago, John Napier of Merkeston, from whom this university takes its name, invented logarithms, one of the greatest contributions to the advancement of knowledge. It was a great step which underpinned Kepler's work on the orbit of the planet and Newton's theory of gravity. Today, you, Edinburgh Napier University's newest graduates, take your own step. History records the support and encouragement to work and study that John Napier received through his faith, from his family and friends, and from those who read his work. We share today's joy with those who have helped us reach this step, and so I invite you to begin today's ceremony with a moment's reflection to give thanks for the support we have received and the strength we have been given by others. I declare our ceremony open. Now, I'm unsure if you had Alan, the photographer, out winding you all up. His speech is probably the best you're going to hear all day. And I'm certainly not here to lecture today. You're probably sick of that. I am here to confer upon you your degree and wish you well. I'm also here to offer some advice for what it's worth. If someone ever tells you your dreams are impossible, wish them well and tell them perhaps theirs is, but not yours. The reality is none of us really know what tomorrow holds. What I can tell you for sure is you'll never achieve any of your dreams if you don't try. And dreams are important, but no more so than the road of the journey in search of them. In terms of physical miles, I grew up not too far from here. In terms of me ever thinking one day I would stand on this stage before you, well, that was a world I could not have even imagined, and certainly a dream I could never have imagined. We never cease to learn, as long as our minds and our hearts are open, and often our classrooms of tomorrow have no walls. I like to tell the story someone unknown to me taught me. A few years ago, I was walking down 10th Avenue in New York, and I passed a construction site, and someone had scribbled some graffiti on it. I can't credit who it was, the author, you know, their wisdom, they chose to remain anonymous. And whilst I've adapted their scribble to suit, I hope I do so with their blessing. And I believe we have similar hopes. This is it here. I've added the word dreams alongside the word success. This is what most people hope for, but here's the reality. This made me smile. It also made me think. If the scribble on the left was a reality, I think it would disappoint most of you. Perhaps not immediately, but eventually. It's hard to believe, but let me tell you why. The little bundle of chaos on the right, that's a confusing bit. But it's where the magic happens. That's the part of the journey in front of you that most of us can't even imagine today. But funnily, it's the most important part of the journey. It looks confusing and chaotic, and often it is. But don't fear it, never underestimate its value. For it houses a special part of the journey that lies before you. It's important, it's because it's where you'll find your wildest dreams. The ones today that you can't even begin to imagine. And take my word, they're even better than the ones you can. Please try to remember this when all seems lost, and from time to time it will. But never stop trying, for it will unravel itself one day, of that I'm sure. I'm also sure, well, I hope, you all want to go and congratulate one another, share some smiles, a couple of selfies and a few drinks, and for me to keep this as short as possible. But please take one extra little moment today and think of the people in this world and the dreams so many of them imagine. For many millions, their dream would be to sit on the very seats you're sitting in today in anticipation of what you're about to receive. For some folk, they can only ever dream of education and sitting where you are today. Enjoy and cherish this moment. Today is about you, tomorrow even more so. Today is the start of what is a relatively short journey, so don't waste your time worrying or being fearful of failure. Only fear not trying. Fear and failure can often be the greatest contributors to a person's success. And never stop dreaming. And I hope along this road, you like me one day experience your wildest dreams. I stand here humbled and proud before each and every one of you as testament to their existence. Share your moments and encourage others to dream. Who knows, they may even become part of your dream. My hopes are not for you to change the world. The world will take care of itself. My hopes are you'll respect it, enrich it, and support it. Experience will feed you like little else you'll encounter. Share your experience today and your wisdom with others. Enjoy this day, and to each and every single one of you, congratulations and well done. I now introduce the conferment of the Honorary Award.
Chancellor, it is my privilege to present Nina Barough for the honorary degree of Doctor of the University. Nina Barough is the founder and chief executive of Walk the Walk, a grant-making charity which is celebrating its 20th anniversary this year. In 1996, the New York Marathon saw Nina and 12 other women whom she'd persuaded to join her power walking the challenge wearing decorated bras. The group raised $25,000, which was granted towards the first research centre specifically for breast cancer. An incredible achievement, especially as Nina had no experience of fundraising, marathons, or indeed breast cancer. That, however, was to change. Nina and the other walkers were motivated to make a difference, but little did she know that only 2 months later, she herself would be diagnosed with breast cancer, undergoing a program of treatment which included a mastectomy, followed by radiotherapy, and then a 2-year course of drugs. Those around her wanting to show support in a positive and practical way decided to raise money by power walking the London Marathon, again in bras, this time decorated by celebrities and then later auctioned. The idea took hold, and the following year, Walk the Walk entered its second team into the London Marathon. 25 walkers claimed their places. However, there were another 25 who weren't so lucky. And not wanting to disappoint them, Nina decided to create a one-off marathon for these women. The intrepid 25 grew to 65, and on the eve of the London Marathon, they set off at midnight with the intention of completing their marathon by 7 a.m. the following morning and passing on the baton in Trafalgar Square to the other women who would be walking the official event. Nina and a girlfriend completed both the Moonlit Marathon, followed by the London Marathon, a total of 52.4 miles and within 24 hours, and the Moonwalk was born. Since then, the Moonwalk has grown and developed with flagship events in London, Iceland, and of course here in Edinburgh, which hosted the 11th Moonwalk in Scotland in June. It brings together men and women to walk through the night over a range of distances, raising money and awareness of vital breast cancer causes in Scotland and across the UK. Each year, a small number of intrepid walkers go over the moon, two marathons back to back, echoing Nina's 1998 feat. Others do the full and the half moon walks, and recent years have seen new walkers, including young people over the age of 10, taking part in the new moon. An army of volunteers supports the walkers over what is a great evening with a real family feel to it. Everyone coming together in pursuit of a common cause, each contributing in their own way and collectively making a difference, making a huge difference. Over £19 million has been raised in Scotland to date, which has helped support a number of initiatives helping women and men diagnosed with cancers and their families. This has included granting funds to the Breast Cancer Institute in Edinburgh, enabling them to not only completely refurbish the breast ward, but also to build a new operating theatre that is linked to the ward. And in a separate project, they've also helped fund the refurbishment of a new mammography unit and daycare centre, allowing not only more efficient use of space and the introduction of new technology, but a warmer, friendly environment for all visitors, whatever their reason for being there. Walk the Walk's own project has helped many NHS hospitals across Scotland purchase scalp cooling equipment to help prevent hair loss for those undergoing chemotherapy. And Walk the Walk have also chosen to support Maggie Centres in Scotland, including being the principal funder of both the centre at the Gart Naval Hospital in Glasgow and a new one being built in Forth Valley, helping to fund a centre in Lanarkshire, and also helping to fund the setting up of an outreach pilot project which aims to take Maggies out to the people living in remote places, including the Highlands and Islands. Nina's contribution to breast cancer causes was recognised in 2007 when she was awarded a CBE for services to healthcare, and she remains a tireless campaigner and advocate for Walk the Walk. Under her leadership, the charity has raised over £111 million for vital breast cancer causes. But Walk the Walk is more than just fundraising. Its motto is raise money, raise awareness, get fit and have fun. And members of Walk the Walk, of which I'm proud to count myself as one, do just that. Nina is married to Guy, who's the commercial director of the charity and father to their daughter. Chancellor, in recognition to her major contribution to breast cancer care, I invite you to confer on Nina Barough the honorary degree of Doctor of the University.
Good morning, everybody. Well, I feel like a little bundle of chaos myself, so you have to bear with me, because this is a huge day for you, and it's a massive day for me. I just on the way here was thinking how amazing life is, because there are certain landmarks in your life, and you remember those. And at that point, like today, you have no idea what the next day is going to bring. And that's very much how I feel. And when I look back, I was never given the opportunity to go to university. That was something that was for the very privileged and for those that were super, super brainy, intelligent, knew what they wanted to do. And so it wasn't even an option. And I couldn't help sort of smiling to think that it's taken most of you 3 to 4 years to get here, and it's taken me about 40, and I came in the back door. So it does feel such a massive, massive honour to be here. I never ever thought I would be wearing an outfit like this. But I'd sort of have very little time. I have a few minutes to speak, and lots of experiences I'd really like to share, and the only thing that I could think of was that you are all on the brink of such an amazing journey. Life is a massive journey, and it is a little bit like a marathon, because when you stand on the start line, you have no idea what the next day is going to bring. You have no idea, and just as you just heard, you don't know the things that you can't even begin to know yet. And that's what makes it so exciting. And not all the things that happen will be good, and lots of them will be amazing, and then there'll be lots of sort of middle things in between. But they all shape your life. And I think if it is like a marathon, you know, maybe I'm at mile 15 and you're on the start line. And just like in our moonwalks, the people that go ahead, if they come to hazards or if they come to something really special, they shout back to the people behind them. Excuse me, I feel very emotional. They shout back, and the one you hear the most is bollards. I'm not going to say that again. And of course, the hands go up, and they shout, and they go puddle, or look at that, you know, amazing building. And of course, everybody else behind gets the message eventually, like a big Mexican wave. And so, I feel a little bit like I'm giving you the Mexican wave here, and saying everybody shapes their own life. And I have certainly shaped mine. And I think that when I look back, the greatest if I was giving advice to myself, or if I was sitting where you're sitting now, I'd say be confident in whatever you do. Always make a decision, never sit on the fence, because any decision, doesn't matter whether it turns out to be, there's no actually wrong decisions in life, they're just different decisions that will take you to different places. But it's much better to make a decision and move forward than it is to sit hovering. That's the most uncomfortable place to be. And to also work hard, whatever you do. And for me, I have always given 100%. So whatever I've done in life, whether I've been waitressing in a cafe or what I do for Walk the Walk, I've always given 100%, because I've always believed inside myself that when you move on, if you can look behind you and say, I gave it my best shot, whether it worked or whether it didn't, you're not going to spend time wondering what would have happened if I'd just done this a little bit more, if I'd gone there a little bit more, spoken to that person. Just give it your all every single day. And who knows where life is going to take you. And I sort of feel that I am still on this amazing journey because of having breast cancer. I feel like I've been given the opportunity of two different lives. And one was my before breast cancer and one was my after. And whilst going through breast cancer was perhaps one of the most horrendous parts of my life, it took me to a place that I could not have imagined being had I not gone through that. And it created Walk the Walk, because I'm not sure that I would have stood still long enough. I was always jetting off and doing things to be able to focus on that. It brought me my husband. It brought me a little girl, my daughter, and all sorts of things that I could never, ever have imagined when I got breast cancer, that's what it would bring me. And I think that always look forward and focus on what you're doing. You have the most exciting, you've spent the last sort of 3 years knowing what your environment is and also gathering all this knowledge. And now you're about to step onto the start line. And whilst that is all good, from tomorrow you're going to be thrown all sorts of experiences that being at university, being at college, didn't teach you. What you've learnt here is how to deal with life. And that's what I wish for most of you, that you handle all the situations that you encounter in the future calmly, focused, and making a decision. I have to say that Walk the Walk, for me, was my dream. Literally, it was a dream. I woke up one morning, and whilst the achievements over the past 20 years have been phenomenal, at the time, I really actually only thought that it would take me to New York for the weekend, which sounded very exciting. And the fact that it raised money for a good cause was a bonus. Never in my wildest dreams, and I have a pretty good imagination, did I ever imagine that I would end up doing something like this, end up raising 111 million for good causes, end up meeting the people that I've met, and end up every single year seeing thousands of people achieve challenges and goals that they never thought they could achieve. So if you want to know what a little potted version of what life can be like, enter a moonwalk, and you'll see for yourself how that can take you from, it is often called a life-changing experience. And I just want to wish you all good luck. And I want to say that receiving this isn't just me and the girl that always could do better, which is what I usually was, had a great time, but always could do better. It's not just for the thousands of walkers that have taken part and achieved their own personal goals, and it's not for the thousands and thousands of volunteers that come and support us every year, and we could not even begin to do the work we do without them. It's for everybody, and it's for the money that we've raised going forward, and it's really to contribute and make a difference in the world. And I don't think it gets much better than that. So my last wish is that I wish my teachers could be around today, the ones that wrote Could Do Better. And I think it doesn't get any better. So thank you very much.
am now delighted to introduce our musical interlude performed by our very own music students. Beat Not So Hard My Heart, written for soprano and ensemble. The music by Kenneth Dempster, words by Jenga Sanner. This aria was composed in 2004 to mark the 70th birthday of our honorary doctorate, Sir Peter Maxwell Davies, who sadly passed away earlier this year.
Thank you. Chancellor, I am pleased to present students from the Business School. Marek Merkrut. Emma Claire Savin. Jordan Vernalini. Winner of the Sighthill Prize and winner of the University Medal, Hannah Claire Wilson. Dylan Black. Jennifer Bruce. Deborah Kane. John Cooney. Janice Ann Edgar. Adam James Harold Foxall. Sarah Ellen Johnson. Faraha Kareem. Cameron Makelzazi Atkins. Benjamin Moran. Christopher Alistair Price. Naomi Cooper Rankin. Marta Ruminska. Colin David Stevenson. Rosemary Stewart. Katarzyna Wiczek. Olufemi Richard Abbey. Chloe Anderson. Stuart Armstrong. Tracy Ann Beveridge. Euan Thomas Crawford. Amy Margaret Kettles. Giannina Anna Cole. Winner of the University Medal, Franco Paul Ventasilla. Asim Ali. Alistair Dunn. Tahir Hussein. Catherine Grace Rudd. Grant James Spanswick. Jordan Robert Stringer. Clelo Zachariadi. Winner of the University Medal, Stuart Andrew Lang. Matthew Lewis MacArthur. John MacDonald. Lindsay Margaret Sutherland. Winner of the Elizabeth Howie Memorial Prize and winner of the University Medal, John Richard Glenn. Stephanie Doak. Aqib Khalid. Euan Alan Moffat. Zachary Peter Javin Powery. Stephen Christopher Simpson. Diane Ferguson. Victoria Young. Oscar Charles Binning. Ting Chen. Bethany Page Leslie. Tejaswini Nukarapu. Marta Bruvere. Winner of the University Medal, Stephanie Hoare. Sarah Wilson. Catherine Emily Campbell. Hannah Jane Ferguson. Mari Elizabeth Swinton. Winner of the University Medal, India Coupland. Kathleen O'Connor Douglas. Edna Vidal Ross. Duncan Welsh. Leisha Megan Anderson. Laurie J. Bannister. Hannah Bingham. Katie Gelsthorpe. Stephanie Jane Holmes. Martin Kelly. Kate McAllister. Alicia McMillan. Kaylee Moss. Amra Mukanovich. Yvonne Charlotte Pierce. Nicole Plant. Lottie Thompson. Sue Ting Wong. Alexandra Fraser Bruff. Sophie Drosso. Jennifer Jameson. Rachel Spears. Winner of the University Medal, Sarah Jane Lowe. Abigail Rosalia Eckert. Erin Gilroy. Virag Heller. Nisha Kilner. Stephanie Louise Rette. Nicole Adele Sullivan, Emily Grieve, Lauren Patterson, Rebecca Lindsay Ward Davis, Laura Catherine Doig, Ailis Foster, Emma Georgia Hill, Siobhan Liddell, Erin Lister, Simone Kate Robinson, Nicola Rourke, Alison Sharp, Laura Smith, winner of the University Medal, Rhiann Lorna Anthony, winner of the University Medal, Lyne Rosaig, Tom Murray Begelty, Megan Bethany Grant, Sinan Kozulu, Katrine Flensborg Madsen, Kiara Ann O'Donnell, Sing Hei Chu, Gregor Anderson, Peter James Lawler, Lewis McLennan, winner of the John McAndrew Memorial Keish, winner of the University Medal, David Christian Schroth, Jamie Zach Ockram, Guanjin Yin, Studney John Kirby, Richard James Saunders, Stefano Lazze, winner of the University Medal, Marco Racanelli, Catriona Fraser, Paige Rebecca Adams, Amy Johnston, Marianne Thorning Bredesen, Lauren Elizabeth Henderson, winner of the University Medal, Kate Wilson, Ekaterina Ivanova, Ayodele Tawose, winner of the University Medal, Sean Cullen, Darren Sege, Leanne Gallagher, Michael Harris McKenzie, Amy Miller, Lauren Rebecca Morton, Craig Andrew Ronald, Sheridan Hannah Hutchinson. Winner of the University Medal, Abigail Ray. Rachel Molly Seed. Balaz Kiss. Winner of the Rachel Beatty Matheson Memorial Prize and winner of the University Medal, Tanja Ferger. Ashley Rebecca Lorimer Carson. Siobhan Cullen. Ellen Rose Grant. Caroline Elizabeth Park. Catherine Mary Carr. Winner of the University Medal, Natalie McIntosh. Eve Archibald. Anita Kinga Toth. Shuba Kaki. Winner of the University Medal, Georgia Colella. Rihanna Malia. Gregor John McLean. Kirsten White. Molly Jean Parsons. Pasquale Mattia Diola. Vyacheslav Serafin. Robin John Holgren. Mira Louise Link. Callie Marie Nielsen. Winner of the University Medal, Viola Stotzel. C. Ki Chan. Kanchanok Chiamasuku. Catherine Connolly. Francesco Maghini. Niarika Puri. Emma Louise Teviadale. Winner of the University Medal, Marks Kasevijic. Sandra Campos Garcia. Xiao Wu Wang. Menji Shu. Naomi Louise Forbes. Madeleine Rose Buchan. Holly Ann Hardy. Maureen Asrath, Lewis Bryan, Natalie Gracie, Martin Krasimirov Kotchev, Rebecca Sibbald, Rory Swanson, Nora Maria Matilda Tuvinen, Emily Wright, winner of the Anderson Strahern Legal Practice Award, Matthew Balfour Anderson, Holly Archibald, Martin Balfour, Emily Bain, Florence Burton, Ravinder Singh Bhopal, James Murray Brannan, Gergana Anasova Chosiva, Kelsey James Collins, Stuart Allen Davison, Tara Davison, Robin Donaldson, Simon Durlow, James Enright, Melissa Lee Fairful, Emily Monica Margaret Flett, Claire Ford, Claire Fraser, Selena Fridge, Brogan Blair Hastings, Erin Esther Illand, Sadisha Nassim Iqbal, Mariam Javed, Zara Mary Jones, Ikra Yasmin Khan, Abby Knowles, Sarah Lauren McIntosh, Christopher Maguire, Hazel Marion Elizabeth McCool, Niall McIntosh, Charlotte Naomi McTavish, Emma Margaret Jean Meacham, Andrew Newell, Jessica Dwenevieve Muriel Ingesson, Scott Craig Nickel, Stacey O'Neill, Sophie Jade Reese, James Ritchie, Emma Louise Robinson, Lucien Robertson. Emma Jo Stanton. Kaylee Thompson. Lauren Tucky. Aidan Tui. Nadia Wheeler. Shelley Winton. Eleanor Mary Cruz. Lindsay Jane Hooper. Winner of the University Medal, Harbir Kaur Singh. Diane Lawson. Charles James Robert Shearer. Jonathan Mark Stevenson. Nabila Ramatula. Melissa Anique Thomas. Winner of the Sweet and Maxwell Law Prize and winner of the University Medal, Fanny Sara Viskovich. Winner of the University Medal, Sion Earl Pickering. Wing Yi Chung. Manuela Muke. Ama Omaka Okuru. Lo Yi Wong. Joanna Josefina Brigitte Anderson. Henna Ania Hamalayan. Ginny Alexandra Dowling. Amy Graham. Emma Hamilton. Niam Jordan. Maylis Caro. Ian Gordon Lydon. Mark Peter McDonald. Thomas Perkins. Naomi Barbara Sutherland. Gail Lindsay Wilkinson. Isel Ozoy. Verena Carolyn Brayren. Esther Guillemette Leo. Holly Louise Kennedy. Miriam Nieto Agus. Caitlin Maury Palmer. Joshua Hughes. Ellen McCulloch. Colm Francis Murray. Elizabeth Robertson. Maxwell David James Thompson. Tafadzwa Mashoka. Alexander David McClure. Joanna Iodanova. David William James Candy. Dace Coglina. Jonathan James Wood. Craig Campbell. Nicole Love. Harry James Craigs Pettit. Ryan Whitelaw. Winner of the University Medal, Kirsten Pringle. Maria Chiara D'Angelo. Winner of the University Medal, Adrian Pang Chun Ao. Nick Hill Kamakar. Ka Yan Lam. Alana Isabella McConville. Claire Crerand. Michael Pia. Alessandra Wilson Venero. Charlotte Bethany Chadwick. Jane McCauley. Winner of the University Medal, Jade Ramsey. Emily Bubert. Alison Dorby. Kaylee Drummond. Simona Aia. Justina Kisnight. Declan Lewis Lowry. Ronald Renato Posina. Fiona Robb. Suzanne Mary Wood. Bethany Rose Kemp Taylor. Magdalena Monica Zebroska. Roshan Danushka Kojagilaje Vivek Rama. Winner of the University Medal, Stephanie North Hamilton. Miroslava Eva Steiner. Sala Surtees. Jana Robluska. Sophie McMurr. Helena Sheeran Palmer. Katerina Balchirova. Winner of the Institute Hospitality Cache. Winner of the Lawrence Ho Student Prize, winner of the Premier Graduates Award, and winner of the University Medal, Sophie Marie Bonk. Sylvia Mazzoni. Rona Joy Buchan. Callum William Hogg. Winner of the University Medal, Leia Arabshashi. Ursula Kazina Dibika. Mike Tirara Zinoriva. Stephanie Elizabeth Teresa Tor. Tamara Trezzo. Dace Zomer. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of students from the Business School.
Can I ask the graduates to stand, please? By the powers vested in me by the University Court and the Academic Board of Edinburgh Napier University, I confer the awards for which you have been presented today. For those eligible for an award but unable to attend today's ceremony, I am pleased to confer the awards in absentia. Many congratulations to you all. Please be seated.
Chancellor, Court, Vice-Chancellor, Academic Board, ladies, gentlemen and graduates, a very warm welcome to you all. I'm extremely honoured to have the pleasure to be speaking as your ENSA Student President on such a symbolic occasion. This ceremony marks a huge achievement, a milestone in all of your lives, and you should all be very proud of where you are today. You all started your university experience in many different ways. I would like to recognise that many of you come from different backgrounds and cultures. Edinburgh Napier University and ENSA are proud to be home to such a diverse culture of students, with passion, courage, ambition and determination. Studying at Edinburgh Napier University means that you're part of a community and a family in which you've shared an amazing experience with and will always have fond memories of. Today you've reached the finish line. You've walked across the stage to a future that you have built and worked for. Once again, we are all very proud of all of your achievements. I would like to take this time to thank some remarkable people who have supported every step of your student journey. We all have that one member of staff who has gone above and beyond for us, who has encouraged us, and who is the reason that we are here today. I would like to thank all of the academic staff at Edinburgh Napier University who do so much to educate and inspire us students. Could we please put our hands together and give them a big round of applause? I would like to also express our appreciation to the hundreds of staff who don't stand in the lecture halls, but are just as important to our educational experience. We owe our thanks to the staff from the school offices, study skills, the student hubs, the IT staff, accommodation, careers, ENSA, the library, the cleaners, and the porters. There is also the senior management at Edinburgh Napier who make all of this possible. The deans, the directors, the principal, and the university leadership team. Please join me in a round of applause for all the staff of Edinburgh Napier University. It is now time for you to go out into the world. You are tomorrow's company directors, parliamentarians, care professionals, leaders in innovation and education. So go forward and carry the name of Edinburgh Napier University. You should all be so proud of all of your achievements. I would like to close by saying, follow your passion, stay true to yourself, do what makes you happy, and most importantly, enjoy it. You're about to embark down a new path, and I have no doubt that you're going to have an incredible journey. Enjoy the rest of your ceremony and your day, and hopefully you party into the long hours this evening. I wish you all the luck in the future, not that you'll need it. Again, a huge congratulations to the class of 2016. Thank you.
A very good morning and welcome. I'd like to add my welcome to that of David, our Chancellor, and Sophie, our ENSA President, to everybody here in the hall today, to our newest graduates, and to all the families and friends. Graduation Day is a very, very special day in the calendar of Edinburgh Napier University. Indeed, for all of us who work here, it is the highlight of our year. This day of celebration is about you. It's as we toast and applaud your success. And so I would like to add my very warmest congratulations to you, our newest graduates. I also want to recognize those here today supporting you, your families and your friends. My son graduated recently, and what a wonderful day it was. I didn't want it to end at all. I felt a great sense of pride in his achievement and excitement and perhaps a little apprehension about what was to come next. So do make the most of your day. It is an occasion to be treasured and to be shared. And as I want to also add my thanks to the staff of the university, who, like me, are very, very proud of your success. They are passionate about education. That's why they are here today. And it is hard to express in words exactly what they feel. And I just like to sum it up by saying they're as proud as punch of you. Now, over the last few days, I was reflecting on my own graduation ceremony. And while remembering that sense of occasion, I cannot remember who spoke or what was said, which is a sobering thought when I'm considering addressing you this morning. But in that knowledge, I plan to be brief, but I hope that if not the words or my face remains with you in the years to come, that the essence of what I say will remain with you for a little while after you've left the hall today. And the essence of what I want to say is rooted in the role that I believe universities play in shaping societies. 3 years ago, just before I took on the role of principal of this wonderful university, I considered this deeply. I have since led the university on the basis that universities, which have a key role in creating knowledge and educating individuals, are fundamentally important to developing in their graduates, in the words of the 19th century scholar John Henry Newman, the general powers of the mind. Through their graduates, universities are a force for social cohesion, for prosperity, and for well-being. And we are gathered here today at a time when we have never needed universities and their graduates more. Much is at stake. From the many comments from the pundits in the media worldwide, to the conversations in our very own homes between our families and friends, we ask ourselves, what is going on? What is happening in the world? The tumultuous state of UK politics at this time, our new journey as the UK voted to leave the European Union, and we are not clear on our destination. Terrible wars in the Middle East, climate-related famine in Africa, a refugee crisis in Europe, terrorists performing chilling acts of brutality and exploiting new media to spread fear. It is somewhat bewildering. So these are challenging and quite remarkable times. And the connectivity of people around the world through technology means we seem to be living through crises on almost a daily basis. Now, none of us knows what the future may bring, but what we absolutely need are adaptable, resilient, thoughtful individuals who have been developed to think creatively and critically, to challenge the status quo, to be imaginative. People who use evidence, reason, facts, and logic to formulate their views and, importantly, to shape their actions. These are the general powers of the mind that Newman talked about over 200 years ago. And in my view, they may remain the bedrock of education in university. Here in Edinburgh Napier University, we maintain an unwavering commitment and dedication to educating our students in an environment where ideas thrive and new knowledge and advances are made through rigorous testing, challenge, critical evaluation, and debate. As an outward-looking university, we are a vital player in a global system increasingly driven by knowledge, innovation, and ideas. And we are a force for good. Together, university communities around the world have reached across borders and nations to tackle challenges, have unlocked and harnessed new knowledge to change the way we communicate, and have helped heal divisions and foster understanding through dialogue and debate. Such is the power and the role of universities in our time. And you, our newest graduates, are now well equipped to shape the future. And my challenge to you today is this, that you use all you have gained throughout your university journey to make a difference to the communities in which you will live and work. You cannot control the nature of the world you will face, but you can control the attitude you bring. Be courageous and be imaginative. As in many ways you have already demonstrated on your journey to today. I think about the students who set up a university law clinic to provide free advice to Edinburgh citizens who don't qualify for legal aid. I think of those students who have now taken board positions in the charity and voluntary sectors after engaging with our pioneering Get On Board programme. I think of the event students who claimed best student event at a national award ceremony, and those who helped organize events for companies like Google and Facebook during their studies. And I think of all of those amongst you who have juggled families and jobs to complete your degree. With such talent among you, the world is truly at your feet. Many of you here today have come to Scotland from around the world, including many from the European Union countries. I am proud of the talent and the diversity that you bring to our community. You have enriched us. For Edinburgh Napier University is a community of learning with a goal of personal and social as well as intellectual development. Bringing students of diverse backgrounds to learn from one another enacts that commitment. And so in a world seemingly divided by difference, here in Edinburgh Napier University, we are striving to be united by it. And as this university looks to the future, we will continue to grow our international reach, to seek out and welcome students and staff from around the world who share our values and will join us on our journey. And to all our graduates, be in no doubt, as you have benefited from your time here with us, so you have made this university a better place. For you came here with unique qualities of your own, and as you learned from us, so we learned from each of you. You leave us equipped with skills and attributes, with, I hope, the general powers of the mind, and, I hope, with a sense of responsibility and a strong desire to make a difference. I am truly excited by all you have to offer. And I know I speak for all the staff when I say we are proud to have you as our graduates. I hope you feel a strong attachment to the university and to the city of Edinburgh. Please do tell us about your progress for your success is our success. And take pride in our achievements too. Speak with others of your time with us, and most of all, be a part of our future by staying connected to us as valued alumni. Finally, when looking for that unique or elusive graduation card for my son, I noted one which chimed with what I guess I had hoped for him, and it said, "May each day be worthy of a story." And so this is a wish I share with you and for you. May your career be successful, fulfilling, and tinged with adventure too. So graduates of 2016, my very warm congratulations. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Just before we finish, I would like to offer a few words just to echo what the principal said there. It's unscripted words, but they're offered with all sincerity and they're heartfelt. Today, you all became part of this university's history. You helped us take it a stage further. In years to come, the faces on the stage will change, we'll all change, we'll all move on. But today, you contributed to this university. And for many years, you have given us the trust of some of the most important years of your life. This university, speaking on behalf of the principal, the academic board, the staff, and the chancellor, we thank you. I now declare this graduation ceremony closed. Please be upstanding for the academic procession.